It's just a small speed. I just want to try it. What is up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today we're gonna be going checking the trap line, and hopefully we're gonna pick up a rat or two. I haven't actually checked the traps in a couple days, which is totally legal here. It's a drowning set. You know, a lot of my sets out there are drowning sets, and then I have, you know, some common bears. You can check those every 72 hours. That's 3 days, so totally legal. Anyway, we're gonna go see if we can pick up a muskrat or two, and then hopefully we're gonna bring them back and do a little catch and cook with them. I've never tried muskrat before. I've heard that beaver tastes good. You know, I've heard the muskrat tastes good, so I mean, I'm gonna give it a shot. So you guys stay tuned. If you guys do enjoy the video, please make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, comment, all that stuff is highly appreciated. So yeah, let's get on with the video. Go check some traps.
It's nice to have some snow finally. This place is always sketchy to get down. Let's go for a little bit of a ride. Well, that trap's still there. I have to get down and see this one. There we go. I believe this trap is still there.
Crazy.
Nothing on these. Well, I guess we'll move on. See you guys at the next culvert. Look at the snow here. It's so pretty. We're at the next spot. Hopefully there's something in the trap. I really, really am hoping for a mink. And if I catch a mink, that would just be awesome. First trap, there's nothing. Second trap, nothing. It's too bad, I haven't caught a mink yet. I'll catch a mink though. Sooner or later, I'll get one. Alright, we'll move on to the next spot. Pretty confident in this spot, so I think we'll pick up a rat here, so you guys stay tuned. Oh, I didn't bring the light, but that's okay. Nothing there. Aha! Yes! We got a muskrat, boys. Got a muskrat. Oh, yeah. Nice high foot catch there. Look at that. A beauty. He's
got a bite in his tail, so.
Probably from other muskrats. Nice rat. Got nice fur. I'd say we caught this guy probably yesterday, but set him there for now. You guys have seen me remake this before, but I guess we'll do it again on camera, might as well. But yeah, we're just gonna put our trap like right there. Right about. We got some carrots up there, but we got a little bit of an apple left here. This apple's getting a little bit rotten there, but that's all right. We'll just cut off a couple pieces there. We'll just pop our apples back in there. Hopefully another muskrat comes here tonight and gets caught in the trap. So I got a set there and a set here. You guys have seen this, but I'm not going to show it again. It's just going to get repetitive. So I'm going to clean those sets out. They normally have weeds in them. And yeah, we'll get to catch you guys the next culvert. Hopefully we got another rat. Alright guys, so we're down here in another culvert. We got a trap there and a trap here. I checked this, like last time I checked this, the bait was gone. So I just went and rebaited it. I just don't know what the heck is you know, eating the bait. Like, the bait's gone completely on both of them whenever I came here, so. Traps weren't triggered at all, really. Not messed with. So I have no clue. Maybe let me know what I'm doing wrong or whatever. I had the bait, they've been in a bunch of different positions, and it's just never, like, panned out for me for some reason. I mean, I caught a coon here, and he actually drowned, which is great. But that's it, I haven't caught a mink, I haven't caught a muskrat. And I mean, this place is 150% used by trappers. As you can see, this somebody's been getting some rocks out of there for drowners and whatnot, but I don't know. I haven't caught anything here. If you guys got a little bit of a tip or suggestion for maybe why I'm not catching anything here, let me know. That'd be great. Apparently tomorrow we're supposed to get some pretty cold weather, like minus 10 and then minus 20 or something with the wind chills. So that's in Celsius though. But anyway, we got one more culvert to check, and it's a pretty darn good culvert, so I'm pretty confident that we'll catch something there. So you guys stay tuned, and yeah, see you guys at the next culvert.
All right, you guys, We're back down here in the basement. We got our muskrat here. We just got his tail up here. We're about to, you know, skin him up. I'm not really going to show this process. I mean, YouTube doesn't really want me showing the process. I'm just going to do it off camera. If you guys do want to see a video on how to do that, Outdoor Experiences has a channel on how to skin a muskrat. You guys can take a look at that if you want, you know, if you want an idea of how to do it. I like that. Pretty sure it's right here is going to be the right-hand corner, but don't quote me on that. It's probably not because I'm looking at, I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to link it up here or here if you guys take a look at his video, and maybe subscribe to his channel if you guys are interested in those types of videos. He does like trapping videos and stuff like that, and you guys can get an idea of how to skin a muskrat. If you guys do want to see a video on how to skin a muskrat, let me know in the comments below, and I'll probably do one. But for now, I'm going to do this off camera, and I'll get back to you guys. I'll part the meat out, and then I'll show you guys what the final products are. So we'll have the pelt, and we'll have some meat. So, see you guys in a little bit.
Alright guys, so here we go. We got our muskrat meat. Put them there. We're going to rinse this bowl off. The meat actually looks really good, so I'm pretty excited about this. We're going to wash it off in water here. That honestly looks like squirrel. Like I've cooked red squirrel before. That's sort of what it looks like, honestly.
All right, guys, it's getting late here. As you can see, it's pretty dark outside right now, but we've got the meat right over there. But we're just going to put it in a bowl overnight with some salt and some water and hope to draw out some of the blood that may be in the meat. So, you know, it might taste just a little bit better, I guess is what I'm trying to say. And then tomorrow we're going to cook it up. I haven't yet decided exactly what we're doing yet, but I don't know. You guys will see in, like, a few seconds. So I'm just going to skip to tomorrow. See you guys then. We'll be cooking up muskrat.
Yo, back here. We got our muskrat here. It sat overnight. Last night I actually changed out the salt water, so we get a little bit more of a extra washing of the meat, I guess is what you can say. So all I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pour out this water. You guys can't see this right now. Oh yeah, you can. Never mind, you can see it. Pouring out the water. Just gonna try to clean it up a little bit. You know, cut off weird pieces or anything that looks weird. Like any weird pieces of anything or like fat, obvious pieces of fat, I'm just gonna cut off. I'm gonna rinse this meat in the thing and then put it in the pot. Because in this pot, we're gonna add water and salt, and then we're gonna boil it to make it nice and tender. So I'm gonna cut all this meat, get it all cleaned up, and I'll get back to you guys in a second.
Bam! Now we're at the stove. So we're gonna put this on, probably, we're gonna boil it, so we'll put it on high for now.
Get that boiling, and then we're gonna turn it down so it simmers, I guess, is that what I'm gonna do. That's what I'm gonna do, so.
All right, so we're here. We got a little Pyrex dish type of thing. We got some bacon right here too. We're gonna cut this up. Well, not cut it up. We're gonna open it up and we're gonna lay strips in here. Took me a while to actually decide what I wanted to do with this. Like what kind of recipe I want to do. So I'm just gonna make up a random recipe thing that, yeah, I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But I know when you're cooking with wild game, you always want bacon or some kind of fat because they're very lean animals. Your muskrat's got a little bit of fat on them, but not too much. So we're just gonna lay bits of this bacon here in the bottom. I know it doesn't look the prettiest, but it's gonna taste pretty good. I'm hopeful it's gonna taste good. Here we go. Perfect. I pre-chopped some onions, and we're just gonna lay them in the bottom of the pan, right on top of the bacon there. So we just let the meat boil for a while, and then we're gonna lay it just right here on top of everything. We got our final piece of meat. That's like some of the back strap right there. There we go. So I got some barbecue sauce here. I've also got some Frank's Red Hot. We're gonna give it a few shots of Frank's, just like that. That'll be good. And grab some barbecue sauce. We're just gonna lather it all on there. Now, I know barbecue sauce is sort of sweet, but this, I'm just gonna add a little bit more brown sugar on there. Just a little sprinkle, nothing much. Gonna grab some garlic powder here. Just give it a little shake of garlic powder. Not too much, just enough. I'm sounding like I know how to do this, but I really don't. I've never cooked muskrat before. But I'm just going off of, you know, I don't know what I know. We got a little bit of sage. Just gonna sprinkle it a little bit with sage. Now you may be wondering,
what's all this bacon over here for?
Yeah, we're gonna put the rest of this bacon on top of the muskrat. So we're just gonna put a few more onions on top here. I'm just gonna put, I know there's a lot of oil in there with the bacon, but I'm just gonna put some olive oil on top. Just a little bit to crisp up the onions on top. And that's it. I'm gonna put it in the oven. I don't know for how long. I'll let you guys know whenever it comes out. We'll give it a taste test. So I got the oven at 350 right now. Mom's cooking some sausages, so I'm just gonna chuck these in while the sausages are cooking. And then I'll probably let them cook like this for a while, and then I'll probably take the cover off and let the top crisp up. Anyway, that's all that we're doing. Hopefully it tastes good. You guys stay tuned.
All right, so here's what it looks like after a while in the oven. It's actually falling off the bone, which is crazy. So I'll give it a shot.
Alright, so I'm gonna grab a piece here.
The bacon looks really good.
I'm gonna get a piece and I'm also gonna get some bacon with it.
So there's a piece of the muskrat there. It's just a small piece. I just wanna try it.
It's actually pretty good.
Woo!
It's actually still really hot.
Here you go, another piece of the muskrat. I mean, it tastes like beef or something, I don't know. It's actually really good. Here's a piece of bacon. We'll see how that tastes. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna try the backstrap. Tastes really good, honestly. If I'd eat that, I wouldn't be complaining at all. That's actually pretty good. So there we go, we trapped a muskrat. We cleaned the muskrat. Not exactly on video. We cooked the muskrat.
And
we just ate the muskrat. And it actually tastes pretty good. I'm actually pretty surprised, honestly. I don't know, if you guys enjoyed watching the video, please make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, comment, all that stuff.
Really appreciate it, all that. And
yeah, let me know if you guys want to see another catch and cook. Maybe we'll try to do a raccoon. I tried that once and it tasted really good too. So let me know if you guys want to see catch and cook raccoon. We'll try to make that happen. So please make sure to check out my sponsors, Duke Traps, Dan Beaver Trapping Supplies, and Long Creek Trapping Supplies. Links will be in the description down below. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm gonna eat a little bit more of this, and yeah. Talk to you guys in the next video. See you then.